Hey everybody, so I've been talking a lot about osteoarthritis, and so I kind of want to switch gears a little bit and talk about another really common musculoskeletal orthopedic condition that affects a lot of people and causes a lot of pain. And so I want to take a step back and talk about tendinosis, tendinitis, tendinopathy, what these terms mean, how I view these things, what some of the research talks about, and then also how I approach these. First, let's break down the terminology a little bit. Opathy just means issue with, pathology with. So tendinopathy basically just is a blanket term for issues with tendons or tendon disease. Then we can look at tendinosis versus tendinitis. Now, itis means inflammation, osis means degeneration. And so technically, tendinitis is going to be inflammation of the tendon, and tendinosis is going to be degeneration of the tendon. Now, if you want to look at this in really black and white terms, the way that we tend to think about this is in the acute stages, meaning you just injured a tendon, whether that's a rotator cuff tendon like the supraspinatus or something like that. When you just injure it, that acute inflammatory stage where it's hot, it might be a little swollen, it's acutely injured within the last 3 weeks, that's a true tendinitis. If that injury persists, and usually we'll talk about chronic, so if it's persisting past 6 weeks or so, or 3 months, depending on how you want to look at it, but let's just say 3 months. Let's say that tendon issue persists past 3 months, that is by definition a tendinosis. It's not an acute inflammatory issue of the tendon, it is a chronic degenerative issue with the tendon. Now, when you really want to get nuance, which is where I love to play around, is in the chronic tendinosis, there is still inflammation. It's just a different type of inflammation than we see in the acute inflammatory inflammation. Initially, in that acute inflammatory inflammation, they're talking about things like that are found in the immune system, like neutrophils and macrophages and monocytes, things like that. Whereas on the chronic tendinosis, the inflammatory markers are different inflammatory cytokines, IL-6, TNF-alpha, IL-10, things like that. And so for the longest time, it was hammered home that acute is tendinitis, 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 and then the chronic was degenerative, 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 so your osis, osis, osis. And that was based on studies where they took little biopsies of chronic degenerative conditions of the tendons, looked at it under a microscope, didn't see any neutrophils, macrophages, any of the inflammatory cells that are common with inflammation, and then they just went, it's a non-inflammatory condition. And so it's really important that we understand that the chronic conditions are both inflammatory and degenerative at the same time, because that helps to modulate or helps us to frame up how we are going to treat those conditions. And so taking a step back, looking at actual treatment and how I approach these things, one of the biggest things that we can do with the chronic degenerative conditions is to strengthen them in some fashion. So if we break this down, the osis, into degenerative and inflammatory, the conventional system has done a really good job at addressing the inflammatory side of things, or attempting to address the whole picture by just going down the inflammatory side of things with corticosteroid injections, NSAIDs, things like that. And they've also tried to attempt this on the regenerative side of things, strengthening with physical therapy. Some patients will get phenomenal results with physical therapy. Some patients will get phenomenal results with corticosteroids, but the large majority of patients don't get full resolution. And I believe it's because we need to address both sides of the equation. We need to address the degenerative side with some form of regeneration, and we need to address the inflammatory side with some form of inflammation modulation. Now, there's been plenty of studies looking at combination of the physical therapy plus corticosteroid injections, and those patients still don't do great long term as a whole. And so it's not that the solution is just doing physical therapy with corticosteroid injections. I don't think that that addresses the issue. And I believe it's because the steroid injections are just so detrimental to the tissues that they are injected into. They decrease production of collagen long term. They degrade the tissues. So it makes it harder. It's an uphill battle trying to overcome what happens when you have steroids injected into an area. And so the way that I approach this is going to be physical therapy with some form of regenerative therapy that addresses the inflammatory side of things. Now, what this typically looks like is either going to be perineural injection therapies, prolotherapy, PRP. Sometimes we even have to go to stem cell therapy. Sometimes we look at exosomes. We can do manual friction and gua sha over the area to stimulate fibroblasts. But what we need to do, that's always going to be an individualized thing, but what we need to do is we need to figure out what is the appropriate regenerative therapy in this patient, and then get them in with a good physical therapist who is going to appropriately stress those tissues, appropriately help with blood flow, help with oxygenation, help with retraining that area of the body, because we know that there's dysfunctional movement mechanics and loops, and everything from the brain down to the tissue is just blah. And so you need to find a good therapist who can help with that, but then also look into the regenerative therapies, because what we need to do is we need to get stem cell activation in that area. And that doesn't mean we have to use stem cells, but we need to get some form of stem cell activation in that area in order to repair the degeneration that is there. And then we need to retrain the body, retrain the brain muscle connection, so that way long term we get good results with our tendinosis, tendinitis, tendinopathy patients. All right, I hope you enjoyed that. I hope this gives you some insight into how I approach tendon issues, and I'll see you later.